Many protests are going on. What do you want to say about that?
I think these protests were little expected, because when you make something of so vast and so big, something which is for the first time, there are bound to be some people who might not like the idea of it, and majority of them do like the promos, the posters of the film. I think the film had to be watched before people put it at people protest about the film. It's the basic idea. It's somehow the crystallization of the Sikh philosophy, which is very simple. The idea behind the movie is to give or tell people, maybe most of them already know it, the basic crux of Sikh philosophy, which we might have forgotten. That is, believe in one God, and the basic principles of Guru Nanak, of basic, the basic principles of Guru Nanak's core philosophy, which he had traveled long time and spread, is Kirt Karo. That is, you work hard. Avand Chako, that is, you simply, whatever you work, you earn, you share. That is how somehow the inception of the Langar community came in. And Naam Japo, that is, recite his name, keep his name in mind. It is very simple philosophy which we try to say. I don't think this simple philosophy, which might help younger generation to know what Sikh philosophy is all about, calls for protest.
I want to know that how it started, how the whole scenario of the film started.
See, the basic, we had to start, there was no reference for any pre-Mughal film, because it's based in 14th, 15th century. So a lot of research work had to go in. The first thing what was done was the 9 Shabads of the of the film, which Sardar Uttam Singh, the music director, and Sardar Nirmal Singh, the Ragi of Golden Temple. So together they composed those 9 Shabads, which actually was an inspiration for me to look into the film, to give a feel, a spiritual feel to the film. That was a huge pillars to make that film. What was also the major issue was to create a film in those times, a lot of money had to be spent. And as Guru Nanak had travelled far and wide, we had to shoot in different locations all around the world, all around India. And to go to every place and make a set, shoot over there, it was quite a tedious task. So, but we formed a very good team for it.
Can you describe the team which worked with you in this great venture?
When we started shooting, I thought I need a robust team which can work really hard and long hours. Few of them were from my previous film, Soch Lo. So I need extensive work on my costumes and my production design and on my makeup, as we couldn't afford the prosthetic makeup from abroad. So we had gotten board the Priti Shields and we gotten board Priti Shield and Clover Wharton on the film. And for costumes, we hired Payal Saluja. She's a veteran. She's gone very busy from NIDA. Payal Saluja, she was quite famous, and she had done a graduation from NIDA. She worked in a lot of films before that. So these people came on board. Alok Haldar worked as a production designer. and we started doing it. What was very important for me was the entire shooting of the film and actual locations, plus the VFX had to be done because of the time zone. At the locations we had done, there were a lot of modern elements over there. And so Mark D'Souza, VFX film supervisor, came on board. So he was there every aspect of filmmaking. So I do a lot of cleaning, sometimes set extensions. And then I had my cameraman. So we decided that we will shoot multi cameras because it had to be shot within certain amount of days. And we had to create a CG character within the live action. So we used multi-camera. So when Sandeep Patil, my DOP, along with his team, he always had a second unit DOP, third unit DOP. So we had to give that very, a very floated feeling, a soothing feeling to the entire film. And it would have been very difficult to make actors to restrict them. We didn't have to restrict them. So I had just captured them when they were acting. Of course, there was a lot of communication, what to say, what not to say, how to go about the characters. So with the entire team, it was basically it's a team matter. You can't, a single man can't make a film. Then there are a lot of occasions when I had an 8-day shoot for the war sequence. And I told Master Jim Hinder Verma, sir, the producer says that he has only 4 days. He said shoot in 4 days because there's a money issue and all that stuff. So Hinder Verma ji has done more than 200 films. He says, tum marwayega. So there were around 200 horses, you know, around many elephants and more than 2,000 people. And we had to shoot in 2 days. So my costume department and the makeup department used to wake up 12 in the morning and start getting ready. By 8 hours, we had to get ready. 8 hours took them to get ready. We could take a shot at 8 in the morning. So there were a lot of difficulties in making a film because there was a war sequence in those 2-3 days times. Yeah.
He traveled a lot of places. So how you overcome the situations?
We knew where he traveled. He traveled from primarily, he stayed in Punjab. Then there were a lot of places he visited, which are called Udasis and Udasis. So he traveled towards Afghanistan, towards Sialkot, and this Pakistan right now, which is a western Punjab. And we have to find locations within this Punjab to suit those areas. So wherever we used to find the location, make a small set. After making a set, we also had to work, be away from the locations because of the sound. We were doing sync sound. Santosh Kumar was doing a sync sound for me on the location recording. Then we also knew that we had to raise certain modern architecture in between. So every area, like we shot in Gujarat, we shot in Rajasthan, we shot in Assam, we shot in Orissa, we shot in Maharashtra, different places. So all the places had to suit those time. And we didn't have any reference of any pre-Mughal film. We had this Jodhabai Akbar, which the Babur came, Akbar came later than Baba Guru Nanak. So there were not many pre-Mughal films for our references. At those times, they were 98% Hindu and we were ruled by Turks. So the entire geopolitical economic atmosphere had to be actually read properly and executed properly. So these departments really worked hard on that.
तो सर ने मुझे बोला कि ये शो है और इसमें ही नेगेटिव किरदार आपको निभाना है. मैंने बोला सर ये काफी एक्साइटिंग है. उन्होंने मुझे कुछ क्लिप्स दिखाई कि किस विजन पर वो जाना चाहते हैं.